Hello everybody and welcome to another edition of the Human Physiology video tutorials with me, Dr. Amir Sandhu. Now in today's episode we're going to talk about this term, endothelial dysfunction, which is basically the first step of atherosclerosis. Now atherosclerosis is basically the inflammatory damage which occurs within our blood vessels, okay? So endothelial dysfunction is one of the key initiators of damage within the blood vessel and can lead to heart attacks and to strokes if it's not halted early on. So it's very important for us to be able to understand what endothelial dysfunction is and also for us to find ways to try and examine endothelial dysfunction and minimize any potential damage. Okay, so let's first start by having a look at a blood vessel. Okay, so if you imagine, so I'll draw a blood vessel cross-sectionally here, okay? So we've got a cross-sectional area of the blood vessel, and what we can see is the blood vessel is made up of three layers, okay? So it's made up of three layers. The first layer is the innermost layer known as the endothelium, okay? Now, the endothelium, we can actually draw just on the inside of the blood vessel. Okay, so this is the endothelium. Now the endothelium is in contact with the blood. Okay, so this is the lumen of the vessel. This central part here, okay, is the lumen of the blood vessel, which is where all of the blood actually flows. Now what we've also got is the smooth muscle as well. Now the smooth muscle is this little part that we can see shaded here, okay? And this is the smooth muscle. This is the part of the blood vessel which is involved in causing dilation when it relaxes or contraction when the smooth muscle actually contracts. So the second part is the smooth muscle cells, okay? So that's two layers of the blood vessel already. Now the third layer can be found on the kind of outside of the blood vessel, and it's known as the adventitia. Adventitia, and we can just put down here three adventitia. So the adventitia encapsulates the entire blood vessel and forms a protective layer on the blood vessel. But the most important part in terms of blood vessel health is the endothelium, because it directs the actions of the smooth muscle. So essentially what the endothelium does is releases various vasoactive factors which can cause either dilation or they can cause constriction. And it's the balance of the dilatory factors and the constrictive factors which enable our blood vessel to stay in a homeostatic manner, okay, so that it maintains vascular homeostasis. So this is what we have in terms of the blood vessel. Now what we need to do is have a look at the blood vessel in a cross-section, in a longitudinal manner. So you have to remember that endothelial dysfunction is the first step of atherosclerosis. So if you imagine that this is a longitudinal image of your blood vessel, okay, we've got the endothelium, which is the inner layer of the blood vessel, okay. So these are the two walls of your arteries. This is obviously, like I said before, the lumen of the vessel. This is not the most clearest pen to be writing on. You've got the smooth muscle just here, okay, smooth muscle. So this is a layer of actin and myosin filaments which allow the blood vessel to dilate or constrict. And then you've got the adventitia, which is on the outside here. Once we've got this longitudinal view, we can then look to see exactly what endothelial dysfunction is. Now, generally what will happen in our blood vessels is that we will have some kind of damaging factor which comes in and causes disruption to the endothelial lining. Okay, so if we imagine that, let's say for example you've got high blood pressure. Okay, so if you have high blood pressure, you've got the blood flowing through the artery, okay? You've got the blood going through the artery to the target tissue, to perfuse that tissue. Now, if that blood is under a very high pressure, that blood is exerting a force, a frictional force called shear stress on the endothelium here, okay? So if we imagine that we've got another arrow here, okay, which is a frictional force on the actual endothelium. Now, if the blood pressure is high, you're obviously going to have greater shear stress or frictional force on the vessel. So high blood pressure gives increased shear stress or shear forces on the endothelium. Okay, now essentially what's going to happen is that's going to cause damage to the endothelium. So we're going to start to get scratching of the blood vessel surface. So we can put that on both sides here. So like if I was to cut my hand now, I'd start to get scab formation. The same process starts happening on the inside of the blood vessel. So you have the high blood pressure, the blood actually scratches the walls or the endothelium, the inside wall of the artery, which causes clot formation. Inside that clot, you can also get other inflammatory cells and lipids, which start to increase the thickness of the vascular wall. So you start to get changes, and you see that on both sides of the vascular wall, we're starting to get stenosis, which is known as narrowing of the lumen of the vessel, which is basically going to mean that whereas here you've got 100% of blood flow going through the vessel, by the time you get to this point here, that could drop down extremely low. It could drop down to 30% or even close to zero if you have a complete blockage, particularly if the clot actually breaks off and becomes dislodged within the blood vessel, which is how a heart attack, a stroke, or a pulmonary embolism might actually occur. So this is what happens as you progress throughout your life. So you have a damaging risk factor, so that could be high blood pressure, it could be high blood glucose, okay, which also causes damage to the artery. It could be an increase in blood lipids. Okay, so you can have increased amounts of the harmful low density lipoprotein cholesterol, and we can talk about those in a separate video. But there's plenty of risk factors: physical inactivity, being sedentary, being obese. All of those factors can actually cause direct damage to the endothelial lining, and that first damage, this process here, is what is called endothelial dysfunction. So it's that initiating step, okay? So that is what endothelial dysfunction is. The end result is a severe narrowing, or I'm going to use the medical term, which is stenosis, severe stenosis of the vessel, okay? Now, when you're in this situation here, it means that the atherosclerosis is quite advanced. So this is an advanced stage, okay, whereas I'm going to put this in green, this is an early stage of atherosclerosis. Okay, so this point here is the point where we can actually make a big difference to prevent the blood vessel becoming so narrow that you start to get this reduction in blood flow, which obviously will then impede perfusion of that tissue. Now, if that's in the myocardium, you're obviously then going to get symptoms of myocardial ischemia and eventually perhaps a myocardial infarction, which is basically death of the cardiac tissue. So in this first part, hopefully we've kind of just gone over some of the changes that happen in the blood vessel over time. One point that I do want to mention is to go from early to advanced atherosclerosis can take many, many years, okay? This could take a whole lifetime. This could be a process that takes 20 to 30 years, Now, there are some populations where atherosclerosis or inflammation of the blood vessel can accelerate happen much more quickly. And rheumatoid arthritis is an example of one particular condition, but there's plenty of other similar conditions where you have greater inflammatory insult within the blood vessel, which can cause the acceleration of this process. But in a normal person, they will start to accumulate damage within the first 10 years of their life. Okay, so in the first 10 years of life, you start to get fatty streak formation. Okay, so these are autopsy studies that have been done in children and have shown fatty streak formation inside the blood vessel. And again, what you're seeing on the screen now is an image of a fatty streak in an autopsy study. And you know, you can see that this is happening very early on in the process of atherosclerosis. And obviously, as we go through life, we get exposed to various different risk factors, cardiovascular risk factors, which can then impact upon the blood vessel more. And if we link this with a genetic susceptibility that an individual may have to blood vessel damage, you can see why it's not very difficult to understand that cardiovascular disease is the leading cause of death. So in the next part, we're actually going to talk a little bit more about endothelial dysfunction and what exactly is happening in this early step, and particularly in relation to the role of this very important biological molecule called nitric oxide. So please stick with this series of videos, and I'll hope to see you again soon. Thank you.